Now I will discuss about the text of Filipino grievances against Governor Wood. Grievance is an official statement over something believed to be wrong or unfair. Example, ito yung kapag yung isang tao, alam mo na mali yung ginagawa niya at nakakasama, pwede mo tong bigyan ng grievance or sabihin sa kanya na mali yung ginagawa niya para naman maging aware siya. At syempre, karapatan din natin yon bilang mga mamamayan na sabihin sa mga namumunos sa atin na nakakasama yung ginagawa nila. The President of the United States sent Major General Leonard Wood to the Philippines as a Governor General. And first, we need to tackle about what is Governor General. Ano nga ba ang Governor General? Ang Governor General ay isang tao na inappoint para maging tagapagmahala sa isang sovereign state. Sinasabi nila na ang conduct ni Governor Wood ay isang distraction sa ating constitutional system at sa ating America's Philippine policy. And this document is also be classified as a petition letter and a protest because Filipinos sent this letter to Governor Wood. Itong document daw na Filipino grievances against Governor Wood ay isang petition letter or a protest. Kasi napapaloob dito yung mga grievance ng mga Filipino citizens about sa complaint nila sa pamamalakad ni Governor Wood. Kaya ito ay natawag na protest or petition letter. And you will know the reason why Filipinos send this letter to Governor Wood when my groupmates discuss it for you in the next video.
Executive Order Number 37. On November 9, 1926, the Government General promulgated Executive Order Number 37. Wood attempted to nullify laws creating the Board of Control and assumed the function of that body. They felt that all people of talent should be allowed to rise as high as they could rather than experiencing discrimination based on race or ethnicity. These were the cause of their grievances. They wanted political freedoms. Because of that, Filipino people are saying that his Executive Order Number 37 was illegal. Filipinos describe Governor Wood as arbitrary, oppressive, and undemocratic. Effective proviso of Section 22 of the Organic Act that all executive functions of the government must be under the Governor General or within of one of the executive department under the supervision and control of the Governor General. A group of high-ranking Filipino government officials together with the Filipino members of the cabinet accused Governor General Leonard Wood of undermining Filipino autonomy by intervening in and controlling even the smallest detail. Actions were objectionable because Filipino self-government was crucial in order to chart the development path of the Philippines in preparation for eventual independence from the United States. The different perspectives of the development policy between Wood and the Filipino legislative leaders eventually resulted a crisis. Kaya naman, gustong mawaksihan ng mga Pilipino ang pamamahala ni Governor Wood sapagkat naniniwala silang hindi makatarungan ang ginawa nitong Executive Order Number 37 at upang makalaya na rin sa impluensya ng American sovereignty na siyang pumipigil sa pagiging independente ng gobyerno ng Pilipinas.
Hello everyone, my report is all about the complete text of the Filipino grievances against Governor Wood. More than a quarter of a century has elapsed since the Philippines came under the American flag, an emblem of freedom, not of subjugation. A symbol of altruism, not of selfishness or greed, American sovereignty was implanted in our country with the avowed purpose of training in us in the art of self-government and granting us independence. Believing in the sincerity of American purpose, the Filipinos applied themselves to the task of meeting the conditions exact of them anxiously awaiting the day when America would honor her promises. The first 20 years of civil government were marked by mutual understanding and loyal cooperation between Americans and Filipinos. At the end of that period, it seemed that the goal had finally been reached. After the President of the United States had advised the Congress, the time had come for America to fulfill her sacred pledge. Major General Leonard Wood was sent to the Philippines as Governor General. The spirit of cooperation would be maintained and that the work of political emancipation would be complete. To our expectation, his conduct of government has been characterized by a train of usurpations and arbitrary acts. This line of conduct recently culminated in the issuance of Executive Order Number 37, by which he has attempted to nullify laws creating the Board of Control and assume functions of the body.
The law creating defining the power of the Board of Control have been enforced and act upon by the present government general and other officers of the government for a number of years, and they have neither been repealed by legislature. To hold that the government general by a mere executive order can set them aside. In the face of this critical situation, we, the constitutional representatives of the Filipino people, meet to deliberate upon the present difficulties existing in the government of the Philippine Island and to safeguard the rights and liberties of our people. The sense of justice of the Filipino, of the United States, and inspired by her patriotic example in the early days of her history, to hereby, in our behalf and in the name of the Filipino people, make known our most vigorous protest against the arbitrary acts and usurpations of the President Governor General of the Philippine Island, particularly Against Executive Order Number 37. The consciousness of our sacred and inescapable duty to our country and our sense of loyalty to the people of the United States constrain us to denounce the foregoing acts of the present Governor General as arbitrary, oppressive, and undemocratic. We appeal to the judgment and conscience of the American people in justification of our stand and for the vindication of our rights.
The gravity of this last step is more evident when we recall the series of usurpations heretofore committed by him. He has refused to assent to laws which were the most wholesome and necessary for the public good. He has set anot both the legal authority and responsibility for the Philippine heads of departments. He has substituted his constitutional advisors for a group of military attached without legal standing in the government and not responsible for the people. He has usurped the policy of Filipinizing and service of the government by appointing Americans even when Filipinos of proven capacity were available. He has obstructed the carrying out of national economic policies duly adopted by the legislature merely because they are in conflict with his personal views. He has rendered merely perfunctory the power of the legislature to pass the annual appropriation law by reviving item and the law of the preceding year. After bedewing the correspondent item of the current appropriation act, in flagrant violation of the organic law. He has made appointment to positions and authorized the payment of salaries. Therefore, after having vetoed the appropriation of such salaries, he has used certain public funds to grant additional compensation to public officials in clear violation of the law. He has arrogated upon himself and right of exercising the power granted by law of the emergency board. After abolishing said board on the ground that his power involved an unlawful delegation of legislative authority, he has unduly interfered in the administration of justice. He has refused to obtain the advice of the Senate in making appointments where such advice is required by the organic act. He has refused to submit the Senate appointment for vacancies occurring during the recess of the legislature in contravention of the organic act. He has continued in the office nominees whose appointments had been rejected by the Senate. Thank you.
So the topic for today is Filipino grievances against Governor Wood. So this is a relevance of this topic. So many of the current historical literatures about the American period deal with the first two decades of American rule. Their favorite topics were the Filipino-American War, McKinley's benevolent assimilation policy, the political, economic, and social transformations that happened during the Taft era, and the gradual inclusion of Filipino politicians in the colonial bureaucracy during Harrison's time. Many of them were written by American historians or by their Filipino students. Recently, there is growing interest among Filipino scholars to move away from American-oriented historiography and rewrite Filipino history from Filipino point of view. So they paid lesser attention to the policies and programs of the colonial administrators and focused instead on the reactions and achievements of Filipino leaders. This trend paved the way to the growing interest of Filipino historians to examine the contributions of Manuel Alcazan, Sergio Osmeña, Jose P. Laurel, Manuel Rojas, and other personalities who joined the campaign for independence. The struggle for independence is a constant and unifying political issue among Filipinos during the whole American period. From the time of Aguinaldo proclaimed it in 1898 until the passage of the Tidings McDuffie Act in 1934, Filipinos demanded it from the American using various means strategies. Early attempts to win it used violent means, but they failed because they were not able to overcome the superior military firepower of the Americans during the middle part of the American period. Younger Filipino politicians worked for independence using the American political system as their platform. They got themselves elected in public office and campaigned for the independence using their respective position. Americans preferred this kind of strategy. So the document presented above shows that by the 1920s, Filipinos had already the confidence to debate on equal footing with top-ranking American colonial officials like Governor Hood. Despite his military background and despotic tendencies, Cazan and his allies did not hesitate to raise their grievances against him.
So the complaints that they enumerated in the documents clearly showed that the root cause of the anti-Wood campaign was the decision of the later autonomy of the Philippine legislature and the increasing independence of the Governor General on some functions that were turned over already to Filipino officials during the Harrison era.
The document presented above is also relevant in the study of the Philippine history. Because it exposes the other side of the Harrison administration, much of what people know about this era is centered on the Filipinization of the bureaucracy and the global ascension of local politicians to key positions in the government. When Wood came in, he exposed the negative effects of Harrison's failures to put up safety measures that will prevent newly appointed and elected Filipinos from using their position to enrich themselves at the expense of the government and other people. He did not hesitate to veto the poorly crafted legislative outputs of the both houses of Congress, and he also publicized the true financial states of the Philippine National Bank and other government-owned and controlled corporations. Specifically explained that the Philippine National Bank debacle was the result of the illegal transfer of deposit from New York to Manila. Inexperienced management, dishonesty, and reckless extension of credit to well-connected Filipino businessmen. It appears that Filipinos hated Wood not because he was pro-American, but because he implemented measures that prevented wasteful politicians from making extravagant appropriations. It also insinuates that not all critics of Wood's administrations were clean and with noble intention when they campaigned for Philippine independence. Some were just employing diversionary tactics to direct the attention of the Filipinos away from their corrupt practices.